It's always interesting playing with like a vocalist or a vocalist that does a lot of like has a like a wide range of sort of extended techniques, because it can, as an instrumentalist, I'm used to having a bunch of stuff that I can make my things do more stuff. Whereas as a vocalist, you have that as well, but it, I mean, obviously you have a bunch of stuff there, but there a lot of that is here. So it's not immediately obvious, you know, like we're gonna sit down and we're gonna play, and you can see like I've got all this extra stuff that might do things. Mm-hmm. Whereas I can look at you and I'm like, okay, I don't see the extra stuff that's gonna do things, but then there's extra stuff that does things. So it's always interesting to play and explore some of those sonic spaces where they overlap. Because mm-hmm. I think we got into some interesting areas where our extra stuff was like doing things together, which was kind of really interesting in a way that is surprising, but also unexpected, which is another word for surprising. But
No, I was actually checking you all the time. I'm like kind of having a cue, very, very seagoing, so I can actually to go that way with my voice, because I like this effect with this kind of, you know, let's say artificial objects compared to voice. So it's like kind of going almost like a tangent, like going through, not really overlapping or mirroring all or calling or response, but like, yeah, it's like it's slightly different. It's not really imitating, but so I like that effect. So I was checking a lot like what's happening there. But of course, like especially now, I was not using so much effects also because I was enjoying this. You know, I didn't want to contaminate it. But yeah, it was interesting, this kind of tension almost. This, and actually this when you were blowing, is like, yeah, kind of going there. But yeah, again, like slightly differently. So it's like kind of, I don't know, going together like this instead of, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Overlapping, I don't know.
So. Yeah, which is something I really enjoy about specifically duet playing, because I think when there's two people, you can have things where there's a relationship that becomes very explicit. So for example, if we're near each other but not the same, there's a kind of a dialogue there or a language there. But if at any point we're doing this, that becomes a very obvious relationship. It's like a conscious decision. It's like, okay, you're going there and I'm going to go here and we can hear that relationship.
Yeah.
Whereas if there's three or more people, that one of us could have set up that relationship, but then it could be not obvious or not clear because maybe what you're doing is close to what that other person is doing. So rather than being, rather than me being consciously disagreeing with what's happening musically, it becomes something else. Whereas here it's very clear in terms of we're doing this together, we're not doing this together. We're near each other now, but now we're not near each other. Like the process has become a little bit more transparent in a way that I find interesting as a listener as well as a performer, because you can be much more explicit.
Yeah, definitely. I agree.
Yeah. I mean, here I think we were near each other quite a bit, and it was interesting to hear that, because I think, I don't remember where we first started, but I think it was some of the high-pitched stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, I grabbed the hose because I wanted to do something, I only have two hands, so like my polyphony is limited, so I wanted to bring some polyphony in, so I brought that thing in, and then that went really high around the same time that you went high, so we had this sort of high duet thing, and then I went high as well, and like, we kind of had a moment that was really, it was quite powerful between the all of the high notes, because it becomes interesting as well in terms of I know what pitch this is and I can hear it. This one is a little bit blurry because it's just going up and down the harmonic, so it's a little harder for me to tell which one of those notes is me, which one of those notes is this, and which one of those notes is you, because it's also not coming out of my head. It's like coming out of the pipe, so it's, I guess it's different for you because you can hear it yourself there. But yeah, I set up an interesting relationship where we were kind of, as you said, near each other, but not mirroring each other.
Yeah.
Which is, for me, a lot more satisfying than when... Because that can sometimes happen, particularly if you're playing with someone you haven't played with before, or in a situation you haven't played with before, where it can just be like a very explicit call and response or very explicit mirroring, which I think is interesting, but not as interesting as dialogue near those areas.
Definitely. No, I also like this... I mean, of course, we don't know each other, but at the same time, we have a communication. So we're kind of, we're trying to understand, right? And I like that also somehow challenging the other person, or like, for instance, doing this very high part. I was like, I'm going to really go really down. So let's see what's going to do, you know, like kind of almost like, okay, I'm leaving now. So it's up to you, you know, choose to what to do. And yeah, I like this kind of also, okay, now I'm leaving or like. And sometimes, of course, it's also you lose the communication and kind of look for within you. It's like not always, but yeah.
Yeah. And I guess with this setup that you have, like, how do you find the... Because you have multiple mics, you have... I guess you're direct and you're affected. And I guess you also have your unamplified. Like, you have just this sound as opposed to this sound. I guess in an improv context, like how do you negotiate that? Are you very comfortable with all your frets and all your pedals where it's just part of the same voice? Or do you like switch into like, I'm now playing with effects and like the how do you?
Yeah, I mean, in my own practice, it's more clear because I have much more, you know, longer, even like harmonic parts, like, and each of these mics has a role, like they kind of like, yeah, your role is to do, like you're here and then it's like kind of imitating or like adding on, like more like artificial, again, effects. And then this is more like, now I was not using loop at all because I didn't see the point. Maybe I'm not going to use it today. But like, this is kind of for me giving always the basis. Mm-hmm. And this is like more where I'm naked in a way. And right now, yeah, I was also trying to understand because, yeah, like now what's happening. But then I wanted at some point like this kind of breedy sound, like just to give, okay, you still give the, you know, basis, kind of like you create a soundscape there so I can continue. So it's like kind of one supporting the another. But with this, I was also trying to understand because now I was not using much effects. It didn't make so much sense. Like little bit with this one. So I think, yeah, I was trying to avoid this because it's really naked to this. And they don't have any reverb, anything, no? Like it's really dry. But yeah, I kind of also enjoy it. So I don't know, like in this context, like improv context, yeah, it's more like, yeah, I'm doing now, let's see. Like I'm already thinking, okay, I can switch that, but yeah. Maybe I will put a little bit of effect on that so I can, you know. But yeah, it's more or less there, I think, supporting each other in a way.
Yeah. Yeah, and I imagine similar to, like, one of the things that I've it's come up, I think, a couple times in some of these, but because with a lot of stuff that I have a lot of objects. I mean, at some point I threw this over there because I had nowhere I could put it down quietly here. Not that that was quiet, but it was quieter than, like, that, you know. So they're like, whenever I want to switch gears, there's always like logistics that have to happen. And often, how do I put this down there without making any noise? Like, you know, like it's just, it's very difficult to set some of these things up. And even that, like I wanted to grab this, but it was like, thankfully it was still close enough that I was able to do that while still doing something else. But yeah, there's always a bit of logistics that becomes a little tricky to handle.
Yeah, and this is, I think, the kind of power of acoustic. That's why I was already just acoustic because yeah, it's everything becomes important, like every act, you know, it's not because sometimes effects kind of help to save the scene. It gives something is happening always there and then I can continue, you know, with the effects. But then when it's acoustic, like every single movement,
And also it telegraph. Matters. So like if I'm grabbing this thing, it becomes clear that this other thing is going to happen.
Yeah.
Whereas, I mean, if I may see you turn it off, something may change, but I have no idea what.
Yeah.
Like if you see me grabbing this, something with this is probably going to happen, you know?
And yeah. It's a cue, strong cue.
Yeah, you have an imagination of what can go there with. Often if I'm using a computer, electronics or some kind of controller, that becomes opaque. Like I push the button and it's like.
Exactly. Yeah.
What's gonna happen? I don't know what's gonna happen.
Exactly.
Now. It could be anything.
No, even these effects, like they're very unpredictable, and they're unpredictable also in each different set. No, in each sound system, even like, and they react differently. Exactly. And sometimes it's a saver, in the sense that yeah, and then it's just part of the soundscape. But this is like the strong cues, like yeah, acoustic objects becomes like, you know, it's clear. It's good and yeah. As you said, that every single thing is like, should I put it here? So it's gonna sound, so it becomes a part of the soundscape itself.
I've thrown many cymbals on the floor mid performance where it's just like pff, it has to go somewhere. I don't have room for it here.
Yeah.
Cool. Should we play a little more?
Yeah, sure.